them that believe. In my name they shall cast out devil. That's in the book of Mark. Mark chapter 16 from verse 15 to 17. And then you have the fruit of the Holy Spirit. In Galatians chapter 5 verse 22 to 23. And the fruit of the Holy Spirit simply talks about love, peace, gentleness and all that. If you claim you have love, like you are claiming, why would the Muslims be killing the Christians? If there is love, why would they be killing the Christians? What the Bible is preaching is love. And I believe that the Holy Quran is also preaching love. If there is love, if somebody say, I want to go this way, must you kill him? Rather, what you do to the person, you preach to him so that he can come over to your own area. And then, I want to let you know, finally, when you go to Revelation chapter 21, he said that there is no temple in heaven. Praise the Lord. There is no temple in heaven. In other words, there is no church in heaven. Revelation 21, 22. Whether you are a Muslim or you are a Christian, there is no church. There is no time that when you come to heaven, God will say, if you belong to Muslim, please come over here. You are qualified to heaven. Or if you are Christian, are you a Christian? Come over here, you are qualified to heaven. No. The simple judgment is, do you have Jesus Christ in you? Do you believe that through Jesus Christ you're going to have eternal life? And that will be done now that you are alive. For there is no repentance in the grave. No church is in heaven. No Church of God Mission. No library. No this mosque or that mosque. No, none of them is in heaven. What is in heaven is the people that have been secured by the blood of the Lamb. And which Lamb? Our Lord Jesus Christ. The blood that is sprinkled on the cross of the Calvary for the forgiveness of your sin and my sin. And the Bible said that he now sits in the heavenly places at the right hand side of God, making atonement for you and I. If Jesus sent somebody in form of the Holy Spirit, why do you people not believe in the Holy Spirit? Why would you believe in a human being? When Jesus said that I'm going to send the Holy Spirit to you. His spirit, the spirit should be taken as spirit. And the Bible said, for as many that are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. Praise the Lord. Sorry, let me stop here.
Thank you very much, Pastor. I can see you are indeed in the spirit, and if we allow you, you can talk and on. Atakbir. Alhamdulillah. We thank Allah for the effort you have made so far. I want to also thank Evangelist Sonny for his submission. Now we have another 15 minutes either side, and we want to begin with our Sheikh. He has another 15 minutes to summarize whatever submissions and maybe any reaction further. And thereafter, you people will respond again for another 15 minutes. At that level, we'll take question and answer. Sheikh, bismillah.
Alhamdulillah. The first speaker contradicted the Bible. He said that Jesus is 100% God and 100% man. Have you ever seen this statement in the Bible? Have you ever seen statement in the Bible where it is written that Jesus is 100% God and 100% man? And the second speaker said that God is not a human being. But the first speaker said that Jesus is God and is a human being in human flesh. 100% God and 100% man. Positive and negative cannot be the same at the same time. You get it? Now, this Jesus that they are calling God, according to what the Bible says in the book of Mark chapter 13 verse 32 and the book of Matthew chapter 24 verse 36, Jesus was asked, when shall the world end? Jesus said, of that day and that hour, no one knows. Not even myself, I don't know. Who is saying he did not know? Was it the Almighty God? Jesus, a human being, said that he did not know when the world will end. And he said, only God knows. Then you further say that it was the Almighty God that left his throne in heaven and he entered the womb of Mary and he was born as a child. Which means that at the time that Jesus was born by the Virgin Mary, there was no God in heaven. That is what you are telling us. Because the whole Almighty God left his throne in heaven and he entered the womb of Mary, and he was born like a child. And the Bible even tells us in the book of Luke chapter 2 verse 21 that Jesus was circumcised when he was 8 days old. Who was 8 days old? God. God was circumcised. Who circumcised God? Who circumcised God? That is the question. Who circumcised God?
No.
Now, if you say that Jesus is God, meaning he was the God that descended through the Virgin Mary, then we found Jesus addressing another God other than himself. In Mark chapter 15, verse 34, Jesus said, my God, who was the God of Jesus? And in John chapter 14, verse 28, Jesus said, God is greater than I. Who is greater than Jesus? The Almighty God. And Jesus said, on my own authority, I can do nothing. As I hear, I judge. And my judgment is just, because I seek not of my own will, but I seek the will of the God who sent me. Who sent Jesus? Was he the one that sent himself? Did Jesus ever claim in the Bible that he sent himself? He was sent by God. He always addressed the Almighty God as his God. Like, for example, John chapter 20, verse 17. He said, I am ascending unto my Father and your Father, unto my God and your God. Unto my Father and your Father, unto my God and your God. Then if Jesus was God, to whom was he ascended? So that statement, Jesus is 100% God and 100% man, is the figment of imagination of the Christians. It's unbiblical. It's not a statement in the Bible. Jesus never addressed himself as 100% God and 100% man. Secondly, we are told in the book of Matthew chapter 19, verses 16 to 17, that somebody came unto Jesus and he said unto him, good master, what shall I do that I may have eternal life? How can I be saved? Jesus said, why thou callest me good? There is no one that is good except one, that is God. Which God? There is no one that is good except one. Except one. We all know the meaning of one. One is not three, and three is not one. Except one, and that is God. Then Jesus said, if you want to have salvation, obey the commandment of the Almighty God. And what is the first commandment? Jesus said in Mark chapter 12, verse 29, the first commandment is here, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. The Christians do not believe that God is one. If you believe that Jesus is God, if you believe that Jesus is God, then you are not believing in one God. Because Jesus